the 5 competitive forces model, the force of internal rivalry refers to the level of competition among well-established players or incumbents. The act of competing with other incumbents within a given business is also known as jockeying for position, as players make strategic moves to change their positioning and displace competitors. According to Michael Porter, internal rivalry or direct competition is determined by a number of factors or structural determinants. To address the intensity of this and the other forces, we should learn how each of these determinants impacts the force by increasing or decreasing it. For each determinant, I will hence build a cause-effect chain that will consider, in turn, the level of the structural determinant, high or low, the level of competition caused by the structural determinant, again, high or low, and the level of attractiveness influenced by the level of competition. Considering that a basic assumption for industry analysis is that competition and market attractiveness are inversely proportional, this last cause-effect relationship will always be inverse, causing attractiveness to drop as competition rises, and the other way around. The structural determinants driving intensity of internal rivalry act as follows. Concentration and unbalance considers the number of players operating in an industry and their dissimilarity in size and power. If concentration is high, that is, a low number of competitors populate the industries, and players are highly dissimilar, so market leaders can impose discipline as well as play a coordinative role in an industry through devices like price leadership, competition in the industry will be low, and in turn, attractiveness will be high. Industry growth refers to the ability of the market to grow in terms of number of customers or total value of sales generated. If growth is high, competitors can expand their business by focusing on new customers rather than fighting harshly to steal someone else's one. As a result, competition will decrease and attractiveness will increase. Differentiation refers to the company's ability to make their products and services be perceived as different and unique by customers. If products' differentiability is high in an industry, customers will have a clear preference for a given product or service, so they will stick with the companies they are loyal to. As a result, price wars will be less likely and internal competition will decrease, increasing attractiveness. Switching costs are the cost customers have to bear if they want to switch from one product to another within the same business area. Switching costs may include employee retraining cost, cost of new ancillary equipment, cost and timing testing or qualifying a new source, need for technical help as a result of reliance on seller engineering aid, product redesign, or even psychic cost of severing a relationship. If switching costs are high, so changing the supplying company within the same market is expensive for customers, this will create the so-called lock-in effect, and customers will be locked in by the companies they supply from. These companies will in turn be protected from raids on their customers by another competitor, so competition will drop and attractiveness will rise. Fixed cost impact refers to the share of the internal rival's total costs that are fixed and do not depend on volumes produced. When fixed costs are high in an industry, all competitors operating in it will try to increase production so as to spread their fixed costs over bigger volumes to cut unitary costs. But when all competitors behave like this, the overall market offer will increase. And provided that market demand is not necessarily increasing too, this determines on excess supply or economic surplus, where the quantity supplied is more than what's demanded. As a result, prices will drop, thus reducing the industry's average margin and, in turn, attractiveness. Storage costs are the cost to store physical goods. If storage costs are high, the goods are perishable, like food, or they become technologically obsolete very fast, like electronic devices, competitors are tempted to cut their prices in order to sell quickly. This possibly triggers price wars and drives profitability and attractiveness down. Exit barriers are all the hurdles companies need to overcome as they decide to leave a business area. Several determinants may increase the height of exit barriers, like specialized assets that can be employed in the industry alone, fixed cost of exits, like penalties for breach of contract, strategic interrelationships and synergies between the industry and other markets in the overall corporate portfolio, emotional barriers or management's attachment to the particular market, and government and social restrictions. When exit barriers are high, companies are forced to stay in the business and keep competing even though they may be earning low or even negative returns on investment. Excess capacity remains functioning, and the profitability of the healthy competitors suffers as the sick ones hang on and maybe even adopt irrational behaviors, like excessively cutting prices. This dramatically decreases industry profitability and attractiveness. To wrap it all up, these are all the structural determinants affecting internal rivalry. By combining the assessment of such structural determinants, ranging from market concentration to exit barriers, it's possible to evaluate the intensity of the competitive force of internal rivalry in a given industry.